I am going to demonstrate how to use Quick Start to configure BMC Cloud Lifecycle Management, CLM that is, so end users can provision virtual machines. When using Quick Start, there are two basic approaches. One uses VMware and a vCenter server. The other approach uses Amazon EC2. In this video, I'm going to focus on the vCenter approach. To perform a procedure like the one I'm going to demonstrate, you'll need certain information. You'll need the name of the vCenter server to use, the name of the VM template on that vCenter server, an RSCD agent must be installed on the VM template. You'll need to know the virtual clusters, virtual hosts, virtual resource pools, and data store information for the vCenter server. You'll need VLAN and other network information for the vCenter server, and you'll need to log on to CLM as the cloud administrator. For a full list of all the information required for a quick start, see the help for BMC Cloud Lifecycle Management. First, they launch CLM, the administration console. Then, I open Quick Start. This is the new interface for Quick Start, introduced in version 4.0. If you want to use the expert interface for Quick Start, click See All. Both interfaces produce the same results. For this demo, I'm going to use the new interface. So to return there, I click Home. To start the Quick Start process, I select New VMware Setup. I use the default protocol of HTTPS. I enter the name of the vCenter server. I enter the port number for the web service interface to the vCenter. I enter a username for the administrator on the vCenter who can access BMC server automation. I enter the administrator's password. Then I confirm the password. Click Next. Quick Start processes the connection information I just entered by instructing BMC Server Automation, that is BSA, to add the vCenter server to its list of managed servers and to configure a virtualization connection. This typically takes a few minutes. Now I have to provide network credentials. I enter a location for the data center. For network switch type, I select vSwitch. I enter the username for the administrator on the vCenter who can access BMC network automation. I enter the administrator's password and then I confirm the password. Click Next. Now we have to create a network pod. I select the port group. These are derived from the vCenter. I click Management. I want this network to be available as a management network. For network alias, I select Management Network. This information is used to create tags in CLM. I enter a gateway. A network. A subnet mask. Unlike regular CLM and BNA where you design a network, this information actually identifies a network that already exists. I click Add. You can define additional networks at this point, but I'm not going to, so I just click Next. Now I'm going to create a vCenter environment which defines the compute, storage, and network resources available for a virtual machine. I provide a name for the environment, a description, the vCenter server is already selected, and I click Next. I select the compute pool and click Next. Then I select the storage pool and click Next. Now I'm going to add a container level network. I select the port group. I select customer, because this is going to be a network for customers to use. I select the network alias. I'm going to select web network. I enter a gateway. A network. A subnet mask. And I click Add. I click Next. The system onboards resource pools, tags, policies, and does a bunch of other activity. Now I'm going to create services, which are offerings that users choose in a service catalog when they are provisioning virtual machines. I provide a name and a description. A description. The vCenter server is already selected. I have to select a VM template. VSA derives all these from the vCenter. For Windows virtual machines, I enter the key to the operating system system license, including hyphens. Then I enter the password that will be given to the administrative user on the new VM. I confirm the password, and I click Next. Now I'll provide some details about the service offering. I accept the default values of one CPU and 1 gig of memory. I'll enter a price per month. I check include CPU and memory options. These give the user options when they actually request the provisioning job. Then I'll add NICs. I click Add New. The pulldowns are derived from the aliases assigned to the network pod and container level networks. I make sure the management network is chosen. And I click Next. Quick Start is now creating service blueprints, a service offering, a requestable offering, onboarding templates, and taking other actions. When it's done, it displays a summary page. I can review the summary and click Finished. Now I'm going to create a tenant. I select New Tenant and User. I enter a name, and a location. I select an environment to which this tenant is entitled. This is the environment we created earlier. I select a service offering to which the tenant is entitled. Again, this is the service offering we created earlier. And I click Next. Now I create a user. Provide a first name and a last, a login name and a password. Confirm the password. The role is cloud end user. I click Next. A summary page displays, and I click Finished. Now I can log out. Log back in as the administrator we just created. Go to My Cloud Services Console. Click the Service Catalog tab. There's the service we created earlier. Select it. You see we have the option to select the amount of memory and number of CPUs. So I'll change to 2 gigabytes of memory. Click Next. You have to enter a prefix. This is used to assign to the names of VMs that are part of a multi-tier service offering. You need to enter a username and password. Click Next. And you can see you are now ready to submit the request for a VM.